means in machine learning there are two type of learning. First, supervised learning. Supervised learning is the technique or algorithm we have learned until now. We know the target. Using that, we make classification regression. Support vector machine, KNN, DNN, etc. Now we study unsupervised learning. We don't know the target. It is same as clustering. Cluster means some fracture. So we make group or fracture. We don't know how to classify it. There are two unsupervised learning. K means hierarchy clustering. K means is widely used. K-means, the name is so difficult, right? The K-means is how many group should it be divided into? We decide. We can say, oh, I want to make group 3 group or 4 group, 5 group. Of course, one group is useless. So the number of group we want to make is k. This is hyperparameter. And means is center point of each group. Firstly, we can choose means randomly. This one. And then points that are closed from each means are grouped together into same group. This one. And there are some wall distance between means and point of each group. Inertia. This one also inertia. And we can make, well, we can calculate sum of all inertia and save the inertia value. And then we determine means again, and calculate whole inertia again. And we can get means or determine the mean with the smallest inertia sum as final means. This is the real mean. And make a group based on the mean. We call it clustering. So this one. Maybe the sum of inertia is small. When the means are far from each other, in the smallest inertia sum can be get. So makes sense, right? So we determine the mean randomly and then find the final mean with smallest inertia sum. That means the distance between each group and whole the value is small. So let's solve real code. So this is the basic library, and then we can import k-means in scikit-learn cluster. This is the data. We need the data as example. I import the test for data. This is some data I made. This is two value and this target, but we don't need target, right? Because this is unsupervised learning. Let's assume we don't know the target value. And then we make each column as this one. And let's scatter, let's plot, so we can get this data. And we can decide the number of cluster, so-called k value as 2. And then let's teach them the model is generated. And then we can know the label 0000111. It's 2 group, right? And then we can also get know the inertia value. This in this command, the sum of square error are used. So root and square are just square error, and we can plot using the after the k-mean clustering. So c value can color the follow the label. So we can easily divide like done like one. It's very persuasive. And then we can also make group as 3. So clustering 3, and then make a model and labeling. There are 3 type of group are generated. And then also we can plot same way. So there are 3 group. And inertia is diminished. Of course, if the mean is the mean number of mean is increased, sum of error should be decreased. So what is best clustering number? Of course, this is on you. This is hyperparameter, but we can get some recommendation. We make some inertia value, and let's plot that by increasing the number of clustering. One is useless, of course. Then we can plot like that. When you see this plot, the inertia decreased dramatically, some value, some clustering number. We call it elbow point. This is the recommended clustering number. Of course, some guy can choose this one, but you know, the engineer should consider the efficiency, small input and maximum output. In that point of view, two clustering is best. When you see this one, of course we can plus, we can divide as 3, but you know, this one is very useless, right? So in general, 2 is better. Of course, when you want to full group, you can do that. So k-means is widely used unsupervised learning. Using the inertia value, sum of inertia value, we can cluster, or we can make a group without targeting, or without target, or without humans, some indication. So when you divided cancel or not, you should use supervised learning. However, when you want to categorize or divide the type of the cancer, you can use unsupervised learning. Or some behavior of consumer. You can divide. Of course, you don't know the human pattern. You can divide the behavior of consumer using unsupervised learning. So when you find some unknown field or unknown something you can enjoy while use this one, and this one help you.